Hello students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So as you know, we are discussing our lesson and the name of our lesson is what?
Yes, that is crop production and management.
Okay, so in the last two periods we have discussing about so many different points regarding to the crop production and management. We have discussed about the how agriculture terms born out, which are the different revolutions happens in the agriculture field. Also we have discussed about the different branches of the agriculture, okay, and also we have discussed which are the sources of the food and why we need the food. So all these points we have already discussed. So today we will move for the next point. Okay, so in our previous lecture we have discussed about the crops. Crops means what? Same type of the plants cultivated on the large land. Okay, on the plenty of the land there is only one type of the plants are there, then it is called as what? Crops. Okay, so we are having the different types of the crops according to the seasons. Okay, so there are the different types of the crops are there, but why we are having these different types of the crops, why we are not taking the same crops throughout the years? Because so as we know, in our India, that is a very big and very beautiful country. Okay, so if we talk about the climatic condition of our India, then we are having a different climatic condition according to the different regions. Okay, for example, we can say that if we talk about the northern region, okay, so in the northern region, in the winter there is extremely cold climatic condition. The temperature goes up to the 0 degree Celsius or into the -5, -4, etc., etc. Or means in short, what we can say, the temperature is very less. Okay, so if we talk about the south region, in the south region there is a hot and humid climatic condition. If we talk about the Rajasthan, then in the Rajasthan there is extremely hot climatic condition. And if we talk about our eastern part, okay, or the east part of our country, then there is a very nice or very beautiful rainfall. Okay, so all these are the different climatic conditions that we are facing throughout the year in our countries. Okay, and these climatic conditions, these different climatic conditions plays a vital role in the different types of the crops. Okay, so basically the crops require the certain types of the certain climatic condition, and there are the main climatic conditions. There are the certain things which are necessary for the crop, that are what? Temperature, humidity and the rainfall. So these are the three main factors which contributes for the different types of the crops, and because of this certain set of the climatic conditions, we are taking the different types of the crops as per the different regions. Okay, and according to that we are having the different seasons also, and according to that seasons and the climatic conditions, we are taking the different types of the crops. Okay, so if I'll ask the question, tell me the names of the seasons, then you will give me the answer. It is very simple question. What is the answer for that? Yes, we are having the two main seasons, which are rainy season and winter seasons. Okay, so according to that we are taking the different types of the crops. Okay, so today we will discuss about the types of the crops. So there are the main two types of the crops, which are kharif crops and rabi crops. Okay, so this kharif and the rabi, these are the words which comes from the Arabic language. Okay, so these are the words which comes from the Arabic language, that are kharif and the rabi. And the kharif means what? Autumn, while the rabi means what? Spring. Okay, so these are the two words which means what? Kharif means autumn and the rabi means spring. Okay, so let's start. Let's see about the kharif crops and the rabi crops. First one we will discuss about the kharif crops. Okay, so kharif crops are sown in rainy seasons. Okay, so the kharif are the crops which are totally depends on the rainfall, or which are totally depends on the water of rain. Okay, and that is the reason that this crop, basically the crops which requires the more amount of water, that crops we are taking during the rainy season. Okay, so the kharif crops sown in rainy season. And in our India, generally in the India, which is the rainy season period? The rainy season period is what? Rainy season in India is generally from June to September. Okay, so the June to September is the rainy season. During that period, we are taking the rainy crops, which are we are calling as what? Kharif crops. Okay, and the examples of kharif crop certain examples that I have written here. There are so many other examples also present. Okay. So which are these are the certain examples for the kharif crops which we are taking during the rainy season, and what is the duration for the rainy season? That is from June to September we are taking these crops. Okay, so this is the first type of the crop, that is nothing but what? Kharif crops. Okay, so now we'll discuss for the next type of a crop, that is nothing but what? Rabi crops. Okay, so the rabi is what? Springs. Okay, these rabi crops generally grows into the winter season. Okay, and what is the duration of when there is a winter season? When we are facing the winter season, we are having the winter seasons in October to March. Okay, so the rabi crops are the crops which are grown in winter season, that is in which month? In the month of October to March. Okay, and the examples of rabi crops are wheat, gram, pea, mustard and linseeds. Okay, so these are the examples for the rabi crops. Okay, so up till now we have discussed the two main types of the crops, that are what? Rabi kharif crops and rabi crops. And kharif means what? The crops which are totally depends on the rainwater, that is what? They are growing into the rainy season. In which period? From the month of June to September. Examples are paddy, maize, soybean, groundnut and cotton. While rabi crops means what? The crops which grows in a winter season, that is in the month of October to March. And the examples are wheat, gram, pea, mustard and linseeds. Okay, but there is a one more type of a crop. Okay, it means these are not depends on a rainwater, or they are not growing in a winter season also. Okay, so there are the certain crops which are growing during the month of March to June. Okay, these are the certain crops which are grown between the March to June. That is nothing but which season? Yes, that is nothing but which season? Summer season. So there are the certain crops which are growing into the summer season, and that crops are called as what? Zaid crops. Okay, that crops are called as Zaid crops. Okay, so let me read the definition of the Zaid crops. Some crops like pulses and vegetables which are grown between March to June, that is which season? During the summer season. At many places these are known as Zaid crops. Okay, so these are the known as Zaid crops, and the examples of that Zaid crops are cucumber, muskmelon and watermelon. See, this watermelon is very well known example for that. As we know, we are having this watermelon during the March, April, May, June. In these months we are having the more amount of the watermelon because it is a summer season crop, and that is comes under which crop? That is Zaid crops. Okay, mostly some pulses and the vegetables are included into these Zaid crops. Okay, so this is all about the different types of the crops. I want to add one key sentence in the Zaid crops, is that basically which are all the vines are there, or the bells. Okay, all these types of the crops are comes into these Zaid crops. Okay, so in this way it is all about the Zaid crops. Now we will discuss about the different types of the agriculture practices. Okay, so to get the final yield, or to get the final product from the different types of the crop, the farmer is undertaking the different types of the activities, and these different types of the activities are referred as the agriculture practices. Okay, so the farmers are performing the different activities, and the different activities which are necessary for the good or the nice or the very well good quality of the yield. Okay, and all these different activities are referred as, are known as what? Agriculture practices. So there are the different agricultural practices, which are, first one is that preparation of soil, second sowing, next one is that adding manure and fertilizers, fourth one is irrigation, next fifth one is protection from weeds, next one is what? Harvesting, and the last but not the practices which are carried out by the period of a time for the proper or the good production or the good yield from the crops, and these all the activities are referred as what? Agriculture practices. So these each and every agriculture practices we are going to see deeply one by one from the next lecture. So today again we will take just quick recap what we have discussed. Today we have discussed about the different types of the crops, which are kharif crops, means what? Which are taken in the rainy season. Then we have talked about the rabi crops, which are taken during the winter season. Also we have discussed about the zaid crops, which are mainly taken during the summer season. And also we have today discussed about the different agriculture practices. Okay, so this is all about today. Now it's time to tell you goodbye. I will see you in the next video for today. Thank you.